I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
Hey, Jesse Vargas, Adrian Broner. You know both of them, God? Break it down.
Jesse Vargas.
I think. And Broner's my boy. But, I don't know, man. It's just like, Broner got so much going on in his personal life, man, that it's hard to focus when you got stuff going on, man. Because boxing is all mental. And if you can't focus, you can't perform. You know what I'm saying?
But some people need chaos to perform. They.
Nah, that's not true.
What do you mean?
You, as a fighter, if your mind ain't right, how much does that affect you?
Well, I think every fight is different.
Oh, yeah, every fight is different.
Because, okay, you remember when Michael Spieth fought Mike Tyson?
Yeah.
You know his wife died on the way to the fight, the day of the fight?
Oh,
no,
shit.
No, I didn't know that.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. And they came to him and said, told him, your wife just...
Why didn't they wait till after the fight?
No, but they did. He said, is she dead? You sure she dead? She told after whoever they said, told. Go check, make sure that it's everything what it is. The camera said, you still want to take the fight? It's okay if you pull out. Everybody understand.
Yeah.
He said,
that's crazy.
Fight. He said, she dead. What can I do? What the fuck? Are you serious, dude?
Damn.
You know that?
I didn't know that.
But I will say this.
What I'm saying is, I feel you. There's certain things that you can turn. It's like Michael Douglas. It's like Douglas, Buster Douglas.
His mother passed.
His mom passed 2 weeks of the fight. But he used that for fuel.
Yeah.
I mean, to perform.
But see, the thing is
that the type of things that Broner going through ain't the type of stuff.
I know what you're saying. It's a distraction.
His stuff is more distraction.
Distraction than
being locked up.
Right.
It's things that you have control over. It's your behavior. You know what I'm saying? You got control over the things he's doing. You don't have control that your mom passed away. But Buster Douglas said, man, I'm going to honor my mom. I'm going to win this fight for her. And that made him fight. That made him fight the best fight of his life.
That's kind of...
I'm saying,
think about the irony. Like, you beat one guy whose wife passed away, the guy who knocked you out, his mom passed away.
Yeah.
But it is what I'm saying. I spoke once to Roger Mayweather, and he told me, if a fighter drinks, let him drink. If a fighter smokes, let him smoke. Don't change who they are for one fight. If their whole career they did something, don't change it. That's his philosophy.
You know, one thing I do believe is this. Fighting is not like any other sport. You know what I'm saying? And I think that's true. Like, you gotta let a fighter be him. Because, you gotta work hard, man. It is hard work. But you can't change the fighter's character.
I think, you know, whatever makes the fighter feel good is the most important thing.
Yeah.
In the fight.
You know, in the training camp, preparing, the preparation for a fight.
You know. Now, look, you know James Toney. James Toney smokes cigars, always. A lot of people do.
He does. He smokes cigars.
But that's what he does, always.
I smoke cigars.
Exactly. Hey, I might be getting a box of cigars, so I'll come give you some.
All right.
The guy sending me them, I don't smoke. Do you smoke cigars?
Huh?
Do you smoke cigars?
Once in a blue moon, if I'm on the beach, chilling. I ain't a cigar smoker, though.
Yeah.
You know?
Once in a while.
I've smoked a couple. once in a blue.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Elie Seckbach.